Hey, this is Brother D, the Praise Louis Radio Show. Tonight, I got my buddy on with me. He's the one and only.
Arsana
go. Boom. All right. This is so cool. Arsana and I like to talk, just bust it up a little bit about different things. And we are still talking about raising kids, raising our children. And so tonight, we really wanted to dive into doing chores. What is age appropriate for kids to start doing chores around the house? And not only that, when is it age appropriate for them to start to receive an allowance, some type of something you can put in their hand for them to say, you know, and an allowance doesn't have to be money. It can be, or you can give them like a reward for helping you or something like that. And how it helps build their spirit and their character. And helps them later on if someone does something for them to share and say, hey, here's, you could have some of mine because you helped me, you know. So these things help our kids. So tonight we're going to talk about let's just talk about cleaning up first. All right.
Okay.
You know, those big rooms we have with all the toys in it. And don't go in there barefoot, because if you go in there barefoot, you're gonna step on something and you're gonna curse. So everybody, I'm gonna get that.
What's the fastest door?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. You're gonna curse. You might as well just get it out your mind. I never curse. Oh no, praise the Lord. No. If you walk in their room at night, they got a little something on the floor, bam! It's like, woo! Lord have mercy.
Then you're feeling all embarrassed because you're a grown adult. Then you got your foot.
But go ahead, Ak, go ahead.
So as far as like, when should they start cleaning? You want to start with that?
Yeah, when? Let's start, you know, because we're talking about, because we were dealing with toddlers last time. So
yeah.
Last time I
mentioned that every child is different, but there's like stages of development where you can kind of like tell certain things. So I would say, you know, for my kids, once they're old enough to comprehend what I'm telling them to do.
Amen. Amen.
They can do what I'm telling them to do. But, you know, like as far as like, it's a different level for different kids, you know, based on their age and everything. Like, for example, Seth, he's 2. So like, I just have him do little things like, you know, he can wipe his little area when he's done, or put stuff in the trash. When he's done with his clothes for the day, he'll put it in the garage in the little hamper. It's something that they do after bath time, you know, like just little things like that that he can do consistently that, you know, aren't strenuous, but it helps to develop good habits.
Amen.
And then same thing with Soraya. She does the same chores and a little bit extra, but you know, you kind of just like add to the tier as they get older. And then, you know, the 7-year-old is a little different. We're teaching him how to make his bed now, you know, like when you get up out of bed, put your sheet up here, fluff your pillow, like just little things that you can do to kind of start developing those habits and that character.
Amen. Amen. Yeah. I found that, like, just like you, like when my kids was younger, when Daryl and Jordan and Ethan was all younger, I always tell people, I used to sing the Barney song, and they would always just love to help. Kids love to participate, and they only know what you introduce them to. You know what I mean? Yeah. So if you introduce that to them, and when they see you doing it, they'll just come up and help, and they'll just start hand. As I said before in the last time, I said, you know, they'll hand you anything. They'll hand you a little piece of paper off the floor about this big. They just come up and hand in their little hands, and they'll just put it and give it to you. Yeah. It's so cute. It's really cute, but I'm just saying, like, if you want to start training a kid, like, train them now, because a lot of us get, you know, we become deterred when our kids become older and they don't want to do anything and they're sitting around the house. I know I don't want to jump far in the future, but I'm just trying to show you why they would want to help later in life. You know, it has to start when they're little, and then they'll get used to doing this. It's a routine, a regiment, and it's like they'll know automatically, I'm getting up from the table. Oh, I know to take my plate with me and put it over here. I know to take and put my napkin in the trash.
Yep.
And it doesn't cost you. Everyone they want to. I understand you want to serve your kids. It's something that us want to serve our kids. I don't want my kids to do anything. When I was growing up, I was working real hard. It's like, well, you can't take your trauma. Yeah. Or it's not really trauma, but you can't take your bad experience and then say, I'm going to eliminate this from my kid's life. Not when it's something that is a natural part of life. Throwing things in a trash can is a natural part of life. You can't litter or you're going to have, you know what I mean? So it's all right to start them off by doing small things. I hope I didn't talk too long, Ox. I'm sorry.
No, that's a very valid point. And we talked about it last time, how we establish what their normal is. So if your end game is to think of it as, you know, I want to develop good habits, then start implementing those things early. Because like we said last time, you know, those are the fundamental years between like 1 and 6, where you're really like helping to develop the foundation of who that person is going to become.
So, yes.
You know, the little everyday things that you do, they may not seem like a lot at first, but it is a lot because you're literally forming those habits, like it's being ingrained in them, you know, from an early age. So like there's certain things my kids just naturally do because they formed that habit, you know, like when they get up, they put their stuff in the trash, plates are in the sink, and, you know, things are just moving, they're wiping their hands, you know, brushing teeth, like just little things that you do consistently to form those healthy habits. And it makes a big difference if you're consistent with it.
Most definitely. And, you know, a lot of things that, and it also helps kids to identify, because a lot of times when they're really small, they you know, kids put anything in their mouth, you know, and when you tell them, like, let's just do like this for dinner. Like if you would just make, their high chair and the table, the places that they can eat. When they're sitting in the floor with their toys, they will identify in their mind. They will know, like, oh, I'm not eating here. I eat over here. They'll know that the toys that they're playing with don't belong in their mouth, even though they're going to put them in there anyway. But they'll start to understand the pattern of things, like, oh, okay, I go over here. Just like they know to go to the potty. Like when you put them on, you sit them on a potty. They know, like, okay, they know not to pull their pants down in the middle of the living room. And, you know, they know, no, they do, but they know, like, you know, because they even point, if they can't say the bathroom, they'll point, you know, to the bathroom. What a lavatory, I'm sorry. You know, they'll point and go. And so it's really good for us to start to develop our kids and give them. And I know sometimes when you're either a single mom or you are a new parent, when you're home by yourself, you feel like you're a single mom because you're the only one there. You know what I mean? You know, no help to the left, no help to the right. And you want dinner? And he wants dinner? Negro, please. You better stop by Kentucky Fried Chicken.
It's a full-time job.
It's a full-time job, and so we're steady giving our kids things to do, and they're helping out, and it will help you get peace of mind, because if you let the little blessed child just run all around, just do everything all crazy, you will find out that it will be a problem for you later on. It will definitely develop into a problem. Do not think that by letting your child do whatever he or she wants to do, it develops good character, because it doesn't.
It
develops chaos. That's where chaos comes from.
And that's why parents that are like always like, you know, just on edge all the time because they can't handle their kids.
Exactly. And that's where your anxieties come from. That's where your anger comes from. Because then when you go outside, you're expecting them to have this magical behavior that you picture in your head. If you want Mayberry, you're too young to know Mayberry, Ox, then you gotta groom them like Mayberry. You have to go through the methodic. It takes a season for these things to be established. So it may take 3 months. It may take 6 months. But they will get it. Usually with kids, they learn much faster than we do. in 3 months, they'll be cruising. But yeah, you just got to be consistent with it. So you, that way your house won't look a mess. Designate a room for them to play in. Designate a place for them to eat. Just like you designate, once again, designated a place for them to go to the toilet. It's the same. It's the same principle, you know.
Play area, eating area, toilet.
Yeah.
Sleeping area. Like.
Thank you. There you go. Sleeping. The, you know, you can pause. Remember the little cots? I don't know. Oh, you got little kid. The little. Oh God.
Back in the day, yep, I remember sleeping on them things.
Oh yeah, you like 1 inch away from the floor, like you was Michael Jackson leaning forward, like in the video or something. Oh man, you lay there, you like, oh, I'm just gonna keep playing with this little piece of string. Don't play with anything not to go to sleep. You're like, when you go to sleep, you know. But no, but I'm telling you, a lot of parents, if you guys are listening today, I'm telling you, it may seem like this period will never end, but I guarantee you it's the most precious time. Oh my God. If I can go back and just kiss their cheeks, oh Lord, oh my God, them little fat cheeks. I wish I could. Or kiss their feet after you take them out the bathtub and you dry them off, their little fat feet. Oh man. Now all that, no, I'm serious. That is such a precious time. And you miss it. You miss their little hand on your head and they touching you, open your eyes. You miss all of that because that is a very precious time, but it's a real strategic time of development where you read to them, you're reading to them, you're singing to them, you're showing them how to be a functional adult, not adult, I'm sorry, a functional child. So when they go to the daycare, they won't be a little hellion and they'll be calling you every 5 minutes. Seriously. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Because your kids will, yeah, they will develop habits. They will start scratching other kids and doing all this little crazy stuff. And you're saying, well, why? What's going on? If you just take time, okay, we're going, now it's time to pray. You pray, we have a good day and everything. They'll start to get the pattern in their mind, like, oh, okay. And they'll learn to share. You know, it's really important. All that little stuff is important. I'm like, go ahead, Alex. I'm talking too much.
It's just like with any other thing in life that you're trying to develop. Like, it's the little consistent daily habits that make the most difference.
Yeah.
That's why systems to me are so important when you're raising kids. You need to have a system in place. You know, one of the things that I had to do for my household was put a system in place. So like, we have a daily schedule. We have things that we get accomplished by a certain time every day. Like, I had to make sure that my life was planned out so that I could fit in all the different responsibilities that I have, so I'm not overwhelmed and stressed. And then also, I was incorporating, you know, what my kids need as far as like time for learning and development, time for, you know, chores, time for little things that they can do to help develop their character and their mindset. So you have to have a system in place, even reward systems. Like you were talking about earlier, I have a reward system in place. So they get their little stars for things that they do throughout the week. And then on Friday, they choose something from the reward jar.
You like, got the stars. You got the colorful star, the little stars. Oh my God. I haven't seen those in years. The little stars. And then, you know what I mean? Oh my God. You got the stars. Oh my God. Jesus.
So it's like a magnetic reward chart that I have on the fridge, and like there's like all these little stars that you can like just put out there every week for like different tasks that they complete, and yeah, it's pretty cool.
Wow, the good old reward chart. No, that's beautiful. I'm digging that, man. You know, these are the, because a lot of people, I always bring this up. Not that my kids was better than the other kids, not that my kids was smarter than every other kid, not that my kids looked better than any other kid. It's just that people always ask us, can our kids come over there with your kids? Can they sit with Sister A? And at church, this is no lie, it's to be, Sister A is my wife, it's to be a pool of kids around her feet. It was crazy. And the kids, my bishop, he let the kids color and stuff during church. He didn't make them, like, you know, sit like Lord, you know, they could color. And, you know, he was like, don't worry, they're listening. Don't even worry about it. You just pay attention. But anyway, but the big thing is that Sister A developed something early with them, and she would read to them, take them on walks, make sure she took them to the playground. talk to them. And that's why Daryl and Jordan never talk like babies. You know, I'm the one who talk like a baby to them. You know, I would like, you know, when I would just do, you know, goofy sounds and, you know, talk like a baby, like, my little buddy, saying stuff like that. You know, she really never really talked to them like that. You know, she'll be like, that's my good girl. That's my big girl. That, you know what I mean? Give them hug. That's my baby, you know. But I would always, you know, with my thing. But that's why they develop like they did. And to this day, they still have a book club in the house. Because she reads to them. Yeah, they have a book club that they all read the same book.
That's
that,
awesome.
I told you before, except for me. But oh my God, yeah. I don't want that.
Yeah,
no, thank
awesome.
You. Yeah, but all that's important. And what does that do? That develops a bond. That's where your bonds come from. You know, it may be something small. Me and Dee Dee, our thing was getting our hair cut together. Because we made it an all-day experience. We would go get our hair cut way across town. When he was a little boy, I think for a period of time, for like 2 years, I didn't have a car. And we would just get up, get on the bus, go across town. All we did. Then we would go down 69th Street, either see a movie, have lunch, talk, walk, go in the stores, buy a few things, and then go home. It was like we made it like almost an all-day thing. So that's where your bonds come from, you know, just doing these things, we're talking about repetition. I don't mean to be going so far in the future, but he was a little boy then, he was little, but those are the things that develop bonds, and they start to know, they get their habits. Like, he knows to get his haircut now. Why? Because we always got his haircut every 2 weeks.
Yeah.
It was a regimen. So to this day, he's like, okay, go get my haircut. They're like robots.
Programming basically in a way.
Yeah, we are, because you know it's about repetition. That's why God always had the Israelites to put the thing in the door, and so it reminds you when you see it, you're keeping it before your face, and you read it, and you know what I mean. You know what to do. You know your instruction. Even though we're not under the law no more, thank God, we're under grace, but the same principles still apply.
Mm-hmm.
For us to always habitually do things like I tell my wife every day, I love her. Hey boo, how you doing? I don't care. I don't care if I'm gonna say this, but don't take it the wrong way. I don't care if I don't like the outfit she has on. I'm gonna tell her she looks nice. Yo, I'm look, brothers. All right.
Oh,
you mean you lie in Jesus' name? Yeah.
Oh, God.
No, but what I mean, like, I mean, you don't have to hate. I'm not saying you hate what they have on, but what I'm saying is that you can find something that you like. That's what I'm really saying. You can find something that you like and say, you know, I look nice on you. I like that color. You don't have to like the outfit. Oh, I like the color on you. You get what I'm saying? You don't have to.
Just stay positive. Find something positive.
You do. How much stuff you gonna get? You gonna get negative. You know what I mean? How many? You know, I'm going off track. See, I told you my mind is go. I was about to go there. Yeah, exactly. I have to pull it in. But that same thing we do with our kids. You know what I mean? You know that's my good guy. You know what I mean? That's my big boy. You know, let him know. And but even though you call him a big boy and a big girl, you still holding them in your arms. You're still kissing them. You're still hugging them. You still little things that make them know that you're tender towards them and that they can come give you a hug at any time. And they don't have to be afraid of you.
Exactly.
All that stuff is important, you know? Yes. So I'm sorry. I see you just let me keep talking. I just said this. Come on now. Do that to me.
No, I totally agree with that. I totally agree. Like, you know, same thing with me, like with my kids, like I don't talk to them like they're babies. Well, most of the time I have my moments. But
yeah,
like, but for the most part I have conversations with them, you know, and like I let my kids come to me. They ask me questions. Like, I've always had like an open policy with my kids.
Yeah.
They know that they can come to me. Like, we have this culture, this environment of affection in my household that I do appreciate. Because it's like just at random times of the day, and I know like it's something serious because my kids will just come up to me randomly and just be like, I love you, mommy, and just give me a hug. Because yeah. I don't see, you know, so it's like just this constant random affection, you know, throughout the days. And, you know, it's just those little things that make all the difference, like to have that type of environment where you know you're loved, where you know that there's affection, you know that you can come to mm-hmm. your mom, you know, and just have a conversation. And like you were saying about spending time with them too, that's also really important. Because I do a lot of one-on-one time with my daughter, and now with my son, now that he's older, he can actually go more places with me. So, you know, I try to do a lot of one-on-one time, like on a consistent basis, like every week. So, you know, whether it's just going to the store and she just wants to come with me, like whatever it is, like I spend that time with her. We'll go to the store, get something accomplished, and then maybe like, you know, grab some fries or something, or, you know, just do something little that I know she enjoys. And she just loves spending that time with me. And the same thing with, you know, Seth, same thing.
Amen.
You know, and you get to know your kid, like ask questions like, hey, what do you like today?
Amen.
My daughter was telling me a whole list of what she likes and doesn't like. So I was like, okay, well, let's write it down. So I wrote everything down. Okay, well, thank you for
that. She's like 2 years old with a pro and con list. Like, no, I don't like that no more. I'm like, you're only two. You're like 24 months.
She knows what she likes and what she doesn't like. She was like, and she told me why she doesn't like them. That's what I thought was funny. But I don't know.
Oh, God.
A little different. I don't know. She was like,
that's hilarious.
She's like, Mom, I don't like lemons because they're sour. And I don't like pickles because they're sour. And I don't like blueberries. She was like, just going
because they're bland.
Exactly. I was like, yeah. Who is this person? But
I know.
So funny.
I'm with her on that. I'm with her on the blueberries because blueberries are so funny. Blueberries is like how they make the candy taste and how the actual blueberry taste is nothing. Yeah, I'm like, this is not the same.
Okay, they tasted this and got that.
Yeah. I think they soak them in sugar and that's where they probably get the taste from. Oh, who knows? But I was like, yeah. Yeah, that's beautiful though. You do have beautiful kids. You and Daniel, you guys have beautiful kids, and that's awesome. And we're not saying that our families is better than anybody else's family. Mm-hmm. No, our kids crap. They crap stink. They, you know, their kids. They have no. They do. You know what I mean? They like to. You know, no, I don't go too deep with it. But I'll just say this: they do everything every other kid does. You know. And, mm-hmm. you know, it's just how you have to answer the door, you know, and I know it's frustrating. I know they can get to you sometimes. As I told you before, for us being with my parents for a minute, that helped me because I needed my dad to speak to me, because me being an uncle of a lot of, you know, I had maybe about 14 nieces and nephews by the time I was like, what, 15 years old? So, yeah, I'm a big family. So, in my mind, I'm going to be a great dad because I, you know, I keep my nieces and nephews. They all know me. I know how to change a diaper. You having your own child and taking care of your siblings' kids is two different things.
Totally different.
You know, matter of fact, it doesn't even compare. I'm sorry. The only thing you may get out of that similar is the smell. That's about.
Wow.
Yeah, you know what I mean. That's about it. Outside of that, it's like, oh my God, because they're extension of you. They're a part of you. You're emotionally attached. You're vested mm-hmm. more, in a different way, you know. And my God, that's all I can say. But helping you, having your kids to do things and using repetition to do it, and also rewarding them, can also really help. I'm trying to catch the time. There's almost I got like 10 more minutes. So rewarding them. Let's talk about that, Ox. Rewarding them for helping. Mm-hmm. Like certain things you can do to your kid, and we're not trying to make them into little Pugsleys. You know, Pugsley from the Adam Family. See, we're so far apart in age. No, seriously, I am 54 years old. Ox, you're like 20. You're under 25, right? You for real? Are you like 26? I didn't know that.
You said under 25.
Oh, But well, anyway,
I'm slowly approaching 30. We'll just leave it at that.
You're approaching 30. Hey, look, that goes to let me know how many years I've known you. But anyway, so let me go. Okay, so this is how I guess when you get 50 something, you know what I mean? You got to take your vitamins to make everything get good. Yeah. It flows again. You'll see. But no, hopefully you won't. But, you know, so when you're dealing with, we don't want our kids to become little Pugsleys. And, you know, Pugsley was the little chubby boy on Adam Family. So when we reward our kids, we may want to reward them with, like, make an orange in a bag, something cool. Like, the little, what are those things called? They're not oranges, but they're real little. They call kisses or...
Tangerines?
Yeah, they're little oranges, but they're real sweet. I forgot the name of them. Nectarines? I forgot them. No, they're not nectarines. But anyway, they all come in a little bag together. They like little oranges, but they're really sweet. But we buy them a lot. But anyway, put them in a little plastic bag and then zip it. Make it look like it's something cool. And they'll be like, oh, you know, and they'll, when you reward them with, I'm serious, they'll think it's something really great. You know what I mean? It's how you sometimes package stuff to them, you know? Just like when you talked about the stars, it's the same concept. You know what I mean? You can write a star on that paper, but if you took that little sticker star and you put it on there, it's like, because it shines. Mm-hmm. It's like, wow. They're looking at it, and it's like, it's something special for them. They little finger, they be touching it until they rub it off and they actually put it back on. But it's the same concept. And when you reward them, you're giving them something. That star is a reward. A hug is a reward sometime. Like, you help me, thank you so much, and give them a big hug. They love that. They love it because they feel like it's a they feel like they're helping their mom and that you're accomplishing something, you know, in their mind. It's like they're helping you. Which, I mean, go ahead, Ax. I'm sorry.
Well, I have like different tiers for different types of rewards.
Okay.
So, like, and then I do it by ages too. So like, for every week rewards, we'll do little things like, okay, well, you'll get a treat, or you'll get some extra time up, you know, before bed, or you get some extra time outside, or like just little things that, you know, I can reward them with at the end of the week, or a new toy or something like that.
Amen. Amen. So
but then for bigger rewards, it's like, you know, a trip to the beach. And that's like, if they're like good for like the whole month, or like, you know, just something, you know, more grand, you know, going to the beach, having a scavenger hunt. Like, I'll literally like turn the whole house into a scavenger hunt if I have to. Like, just little things that I do just to give them incentives. And then now with Soraya, we have potty rewards.
Oh, God. For one lump, you get the... you get a thing. But for two lumps, my God, you know, you get to stay up past 10 o'clock.
Not quite. No, but, you know, just for her consistently doing it, like, there are rewards, like certain special toys that I put aside, and I'm like, okay, well, you know, if you do this for this week, this will be your reward, or if you do that. So, you know, I give her like incentives and stuff to work towards.
Yeah.
That way she knows, like, okay, if I'm good, or if I'm, you know, consistently good, then I can get this or do that. So it helps.
Amen. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. That's cool, though. Your tiers of reward, and that's true. When in retrospect, when you think about it, I always would promise, you know, I bring you home this, I bring you home that. What you want dad to bring you home? Well, yeah, be on the phone with them. Yeah, they get excited. I used to love giving my kids allowance when they was little, like 7 and 8 and stuff. I would go to the credit union. They knew every pay week I would get 10 $1 bills and put them in an envelope and put their name on it. And they just, and they couldn't wait to, because they thought they had so much money. But if you give them 2 5 or 10, it's like, yo, I want the, they want the ones, they want to make it rain. I have to do that today. Yo, man, that was just so funny. They used to love it, man. They used to take their money. Like, pay attention. Here's a dollar for my tithes. And then... Yo, Oxford, I tell you, I love it. Man, Jesus. This is something. Woo, God, it's so good. But no, seriously, because you think about those times and you think about what it meant to them, and you feel so rewarded as a parent to do anything for your kid. Even when you take them to like up here, I don't know if you have Reader's Water Ice down here, but up here is Reader's is really we go down and we get gelatis and everything, and you just see them and you see them, their little hand, they be eating their stuff and they hold their little spoon. That's where I get my joy from. I just be sitting there laughing, just looking at them. They be grubbing, man, eating their little pretzel. I'll be like, look at my baby. Oh, man.
Yeah, mine are still really young, so I don't really like give them allowance yet. I just put everything that they get into a savings account.
Oh, yeah.
So when they're older, then yeah, and I'll teach them what to do with it, and like how to manage it. Okay, well, put this amount aside for this and this amount for that, and then you have this amount to do what you want with. And so I'm looking forward to
Yeah.
that. We're not there just yet, but I do have a plan already in place for that.
Yeah, big time. Big time. It's good. It's good to have. I mean, and every household is not going to be, carbon copies. You know what I mean? It's you get to come up with your own thing. Nothing oppressive, hopefully. But you get to come up with your own, how you want to do stuff, and don't just do stuff to your kids or like because once again, because your parents didn't let you do it. You know what I mean? That's not really love. You know what I mean? That's not, I'm not gonna do that because they did it. You know what I mean? They'll be able to go out and stay out all night. It's like you're stupid. You know, don't, you know. I mean, you know what I mean? I let my kids stay up until, we had to go to bed by 9:30 every night. Well, it was a reason for that for some people because you had to get up early and you probably wasn't an early riser. So your mom had to give you a probably a buffer time to get you up because it takes a half an hour for you to get out of bed. You get what I'm saying? So it wasn't that they were doing it to help oppress you. They were doing it to help you. I mean. I know,
I
right?
can see the sun.
All right, well, I'll catch you next go around.
I believe the storm is
enjoy your
passing
night.
Over.
Tell Dan. Tell Dan I took a job.
Definitely.
All right.
There is a blessing waiting on you.
Waiting on you.
God's about to come through.
I can feel a breakthrough.